Hey guys, Simon Brayson here, and so I have a third channel I just started where I have people ask me questions live and basically talk to me one-on-one. Now, I got a call yesterday about someone that said, Tommy, I don't want to be on YouTube, but it's okay to share my story, no problem, right? And the idea is that this person, I won't say the name, obviously, well, he has a car loan for around $28,000. On top of that, he only makes around $500 per week, and his interest rate is well over 20%. And the car is only worth, wait for it, is only worth $14,000. So even if he went ahead and paid for the car, how the heck is he supposed to pay all that money left over and that loan? And how the heck is he supposed to sell a car only worth $14,000 and the buyer basically knows, hey, this car has a loan on it for over $28,000? And you've been paying basically payments, but only around 50 to 90 bucks in capital payments. It's an insane situation. And that's what's for this video. I wanna help you guys figure out exactly, hey, if I bought a car that was too expensive, how can I sell it? And it's actually financed still, to then go ahead and try to cut my losses. This way, I can finally get out of this burden, okay? And by the way, if you're going to do this, but you need transportation, obviously, you're going to need to go out there and buy a beater car for $1,000, $1,200, $1,500. That way, at least, you can transport yourself across from point A to point B while you're actually building up your financial freedom to then go ahead and buy a decent car that you actually want to buy. But this stuff, man, if I'm being honest here, it's one of the scariest things. People love buying fancy cars that lose a ton of value and still owe a ton of money on it, and I don't understand why. At least for me, I just don't care about cars that much, but I know for a fact people love cars. They love cars so much, okay? I used to want a Lamborghini, a Cayenne Porsche, and now today, I just basically downgraded all the way down to a Toyota Corolla, like a 2014 to 2017 model, but that's what I'm gonna get, and that's final, and I'll also pay cash for it. Now, if you guys are new here, guys, I post videos every single day, so you should also subscribe and hit the bell to get notified, and on top of that, also destroy the like button. And by the way, if you wanna check out my third channel, well, link down below to the Ask Simon Brayson channel. You can come on and basically ask me any questions whenever you actually want, okay? Check the channel out, link down below. Now, the very first thing you wanna find out is basically, if I have this car and I wanna sell it to cut my losses and get out of debt, what's the first thing I need to find out? The answer is I have to find out exactly what the car value actually is. Usually, Kelly's Blue Book is going to be great for that. You want Kelly's Blue Book, you find out, hey, this is my model, my car, how much does it go for? You find that out and that'll tell you exactly how much you can actually sell it for in the open market, okay? And usually, if I'm being honest here, most of the times, when you do sell the car, you're probably still going to have a balance on the loan because basically you can't really sell the car for enough money because again, when you buy a car, you drive it off the lot, that's 10%. By the end of the year, that's 20%. Within 3 to 5 years, that 50% of that value is gone just like that, eradicated. And that's why the guy that called me, man, that stuff is scary, right? You buy a car, $28,000 for it, so nice, so great. All of a sudden, you've been paying your payments, but nothing's been going towards capital, so you still owe a ton of money. And guess what? Now the car is only worth $14,000. So even if I sell this car for $14,000 at the top of the market, right? I still owe $14,000 on this car. How the heck am I supposed to get out of this? On top of that, I'm still paying 20% or more in interest. That is crazy, okay? You never want to agree to any deal like that ever. You never want to buy a car that's too expensive that you can't afford in cash. That is usually going to be a bad idea. Buy a car you can afford with cash, you're good to go. Again, a car is from point A to point B. It does not matter if you get there, for example, in a Mercedes or a Honda. Nobody cares. Nobody cares. You think people care, but they really don't care. But guys, number two here is once you find out the value of this car, well, how do you go out there and sell it? You know, the biggest thing is basically, if I am a buyer, do I wanna buy a car that has a lien against it or a loan on it? How difficult is it gonna be? I have to trust you now, all this stuff, right? So how do I make sure if I'm gonna buy this car that you're actually gonna pay off the loan and I don't get stuck with a bill that I don't wanna get stuck with? So how do you make sure as a seller you sell it fast and quickly and safely for a buyer? The answer is usually you're gonna have two options, okay? The first option is gonna be basically an escrow company, and the second option is basically making a bill of sale contract. Now, the first thing is this, guys, okay? Escrow. So, for example, guys, okay, if we're gonna use the escrow company, here's what you wanna do. The escrow company is going to be in charge of keeping the money while every single requirement is met. So if I tell the buyer, hey, you can basically give me the money, and once basically the car is paid off and the title is basically going to be sent to you, I can go ahead and grab that money out. If they say yes, then great. Those are the things that the escrow company is going to worry about. But tell me, escrow companies are not free. Yes, usually they're going to charge you around like 1.5%. If you sell it for 10K, it's around $150. Not that much at all. But overall, an escrow company is going to give confidence to the buyer buying that car. But the big problem is, hey, Tommy, how the heck am I supposed to pay off this loan if the money is stuck with the escrow company and I still can't get enough to pay the loan off? Well, that's the big problem there. So then you have the option of, hey, maybe I can do, for example, a bill of sale. When I say, hey, all right, so this car is only worth maybe 10K, right? The loan on it is basically 5K left, right? Bill of sale says, hey, once you pay me this money, I'm gonna go ahead and pay off this like, car, right? And this way, once basically the title comes in, I'll transfer it over to you. That's everything that the bill of sale has to say. Again, a bill of sale is going to be in a way like a contract. So don't do this by Googling it. No, you go to basically a notary to confirm everything, and also a lawyer to basically draw it out for you. This way you know exactly how everything is going to work and make sure everything is tip-top shape. There's not a problem with buying a car with a loan on it or a lien on it. It's possible, no problem there. But the answer is you gotta make sure all your ducks in a row so you don't end up getting finessed, okay? You never know what's going to happen. You don't wanna do like a handshake deal like, hey, yeah, I'll pay the car off. Just take it with you, okay? Before you know it, it's being repossessed, and that is not what you want. Now, guys, if escrow is not going to work or a bill of sale is not gonna work, you always have the option to say, hey, all right, you know what I'll do is, okay, I have this car here. I'll sell it for X amount. I'll also go ahead and borrow the money basically from an unsecured loan, like just like a personal loan. I'll use that money plus basically the entire sale of the money, right? The sale of the car, put it together, pay off the whole lender, boom, it's paid off. The person that bought the car gets the title in 2 to 4 weeks or whatever, boom, everything's taken care of. And now you only have basically one payment to worry about, and you're just going to be basically at a lower rate. Now, this only works if basically you have a decent credit score. And while you're doing this, obviously, you're going to need to get a better car. Because I know for a fact, hey, Tommy, I need a car to get to work. No car, no job, no job, no money, no money, no nothing, right? So overall, you might have to go ahead and buy a beater car. You get a loan, you sell the car, you pay the loan off. The buyer gets basically like the title of the car. And by the way, this should all be included also in the bill of sale. Hey, I'm gonna get a loan for the entire thing. I'll use that money to go ahead and pay the remainder of the loan balance. With your money, I'll also do that. That's the whole thing. Number three here is using the loan as a part of the purchase price. Meaning, for example, if I'm gonna be the buyer, right? And this car is worth maybe, for example, 15K. I wanna pay 15K for it. But you have, for example, a loan left in it of around 10K, right? I go directly to the lender and say, hey, let's go to the lender. I'll write a check for $10,000. Boom, that's cleared. Transfer the title over to me. And then once that's done, I'll go ahead and give you, for example, the $5,000, okay? That way, everything is taken care of. But usually it's going to be, hey, bill of sale, escrow, or going directly to the lender and doing the whole deal that way. Now, the scary part is basically, there's no way around it, okay? If you owe a ton of money in a car that's not worth that much, you're going to need to basically finesse the heck out of it. You might go ahead and basically have to borrow some money or basically try to pay off as possible, but that's the whole idea. It is tough. And the best way to avoid this is basically just don't buy a car you cannot afford. And that's why when I buy a car, I'm going to follow the buy a used car rule. You know, if you buy a car, right? Think about this, guys, okay? If we know that a car loses value, it's out of value by year 3 or year 5, what do? You buy that car around year 3 or year 5, and guess what? You get a massive discount. You buy a 3 to 5 year old car, you know, certified to use it, for example, take it to a mechanic, make sure it's good, solid, oil, everything is good, right? That's the whole idea. If the car is solid, you go ahead and buy it for a good price. Once you buy the car, basically, make sure you pay cash for it. And you ride that car until the wheels fall off or until you can go ahead and buy a newer car, a nice car. We can actually afford it, for example, out of pocket. That's the whole idea here. So, although my first car is going to be a Toyota Corolla, my next car can be, for example, maybe like a Cayenne Porsche, a Lamborghini. Probably not, honestly. I'm not going to buy that at all. But maybe like a nice car, like a nice, nice car, maybe like a Tesla, something like that. But only when I can go ahead and say, hey, I can buy this car and not worry about my investments or anything like that, okay? That's the whole idea. Usually, investments first, car later. Car later, car later, car later. Guys, but that's about it for this video. Comment down below. Let me know if it was helpful. Any ideas, also comment down below and let me know. And by the way, it's like it's complicated, right? Because you're trying to like sell a car, has balance on it, and you need to find a buyer that's educated on it and knows, hey, it's okay. I'm not going to scam as long as I do everything correct with an escrow company or a bill of sale or basically just using the purchase price to basically go ahead and pay off the loan and make a difference, okay? That's the whole idea for this video. I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. And as always, if you like this video right here, guys, well, like this video on top of it. Also, subscribe and hit the bell so you're notified. If you guys want to text me or talk to me one-on-one, join my Patreon link down below or send me a DM on Instagram at Tommy Bryson. And before I go, if you want to watch another video, here it is right here, another car video, okay? And top, but also click my face right here. See you guys tomorrow. Thanks for watching, and as always, peace.